That's the motion. So, I move to cite in contempt. Sandali lang po, co-chair. Abante, give me the time because this is my time to answer questions being asked by almost all members. Paulit-ulit lang yung perhaps mo. I move to cite in contempt Ms. Garma for lying and evading questions being asked by the members of this committee and including this representation. So move, Mr. Chairman.
In my mother's grave, yung travel ko sa state, sinabi ko na po ang totoo. I have a daughter waiting for me who attempted to kill herself 3 times. I cannot leave her, Mr. Chair. She's waiting for me. With regards to my travels, that's the real answer. I do not know why my visa was cancelled, Mr. Okay. Chair.
Okay.
Mukhang puno ng drama mo, Eksena.
You can validate that if magtanong kayo sa Japan kung bakit they didn't give me the exact answer.
Mukhang puno ng drama mo, Eksena. Panoorin natin ang full highlights video.
There were already 3 occasions wherein Colonel Garma had a contact with Jimmy Fortaleza and personally talking to Jimmy Fortaleza, whether on the phone o dun sa Dapicol. Ang pang-apat po, nung August 11 na, nung pinasok na po yung 3 bilanggo na Chinese na para patayin, tumawag din po ulit si Colonel Garma kay Jimmy Fortaleza at sinabayhan, huwag mong pabayaan yung 3 bilanggo, bigyan mo, alagaan mo, bigyan mo ng pagkain. So it's very clear, Mr. Chair, that it was Colonel Garma who was directing everything to kill these 3 Chinese nationals. Ngayon, I'd also like to establish a point wherein doon sa affidavit ni Joby Espinido that during the war against drugs, there indeed was a reward system. Kung makapatay ang pulis ng mga drug lord or whatever na involved sa kaso ng droga, there was a reward system wherein binibigyan ang pulis na nakapatay ng 20,000. Now accordingly, nanggaling sa STL yung pondo na ibayad doon sa mga reward sa mga pulis. Colonel Garma, totoo po ba na nanggaling ang pera para sa reward system? Nanggaling po ba sa STL?
No, Your Honor.
Nung kayo po ay nakaposisyon?
No, Your Honor.
Pero inaamin ho ninyo na noong November 2021 and during your stint as STL ahead, nagbibigay po kayo ng pondo sa PNP, hindi po ba?
For medical programs, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, prior to your stint, Colonel Garma, yung STL operations po, sinuspend ho yun?
1/2 of STL agents po ay may utang sa PCSO. More than 5 billion.
Pero kayo din po ang nag-lift, hindi po ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair, after the implementing rules and regulations was approved by the Office of the President, Mr. Chair.
Sa tingin ninyo, Madam Garma, hindi kaya yung binibigyan yung pera sa PNP, sa NBI, ay nagamit as a reward dun sa mga nakapatay ng mga drug lord?
Hindi po pwede yun, Mr. Chair.
Kasi po, kayo na po nagsabi sa isang interview noon na ang income na generated sa STL and Lotto ay nagbibigay po kayo ng portion sa NBI and PNP bilang reward sa mga efforts nila na labanan ang underground illegal gambling and illegal drugs. Hindi po ba?
No, Mr.
In terms of the knowledge of our research person, kasi nabanggit din dati ni former Senator Leila De Lima na bago naging nationwide ang Oplan Tokhang, meron ng Davao Death Squad na nag-exist para gawing peaceful yung Davao City, Mr. Chair. Ano po ang pagkakaalam ni Colonel Garma sa existence ng Davao Death Squad at sa mga operations nito sa Davao City?
Wala po, Your Honor.
Can you qualify po? Wala kayong nalalaman or walang existence yung Davao Death Squad?
wala po akong alam, wala po akong nakita. I'm explaining my answer based on my personal knowledge, Ms. Your Honor.
So despite po yung evidence, yung maraming ebidensya ng mga ginawa ng Davao Death Squad at matagal din po na na-assign sa Davao City si Colonel Garma, tingin po niya ay hindi totoo na may Davao Death Squad. Ganun po ba?
Mr. Chair, I do not know what evidence you're referring to. I am just speaking on what I know personally, what I saw, what I hear, what I felt. May 5 senses lang po ang ginagamit ko dito.
E di kung ano yung mga hindi niya na-observe, ano yung hindi niya mga nagawa, kung ano yung mga injustisya na napalampas dun sa Davao City, that can actually point to, at the minimum, Mr. Chair, neglect dun sa trabaho, or maximum, ay pagkonsente o pag-implement mismo nung injustisya para mag-create ng semblance ng peace and order sa mga lugar kung saan siya na-assign. Ganon din ba yung estilo na dinala ni Colonel Garma nung siya ay na-assign na sa Cebu? Paano pinatupad yung war on drugs nung doon na po kaya na-assign?
Mr. Chair, during my stint as the City Director of Cebu City Police Office, I intensified police patrol.
Meron pong nag-testify si Colonel Espinido sa nakaraang hearings na bahagi talaga ng pag-neutralize ay yung pagpatay dun sa mga nililabel na mga drug pushers. So, sa stint niyo as Cebu City Police Office Director, ilan yung tala ng mga napatay na mga drug suspects sa ilalim ng inyong pamumuno?
Mr. Chair, may I be clarified on your definition ng napatay?
Mr. Chair, it seems na evasive po yung mga sagot ng ating resource person. Consistent po dun sa paano tinatrato ng dating administrasyon yung mga ganitong pagpatay. Hindi lang doon mismo sa loob ng ating mga penal farms, ganyan, pero maging doon sa labas mismo, no? Doon sa ating mga ordinaryong kabataan.
Tinatanong ko kasi yung mga katanungan ito, Colonel Garma, dahil lumalabas po sa mga testimonya ng ilang saksi na kayo po ang tinuturo bilang nag-uutos or namumuno ng operasyon sa pagpatay ng Chinese nationals sa Dapicol. Not just one or two, three. Tatlong sinumpang salaysay point to you as the mastermind behind this.
I do not understand the facts of the...
Hypothetical question lang po, Colonel Garma. And in your expert opinion, as CIDG, part of CIDG din dati, kung may isasagawang operasyon sa loob ng Piitan to gather information, kailangan po ba ng participation or approval ng warden para magawa itong operation na ito? Hypothetical lang po, based on your expert opinion po. Kailangan po ba?
Is it Mr. Chair?
Kailangan po ba?
It depends.
Ng approval or cooperation ng warden?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So, if for example, yung operasyon naman na iyon is to further charge or to kill anybody inside the penal colony, kailangan po ba 'to ng approval or cooperation ng warden?
That is a illegal activity, Your Honor. I don't even want to give my opinion on that.
Ma'am, you are decorated. You are in the CIG, CIDG, which means that these kinds of investigations are no stranger to you. You would know to be able to solve a case and to investigate it well, kailangan nyo rin na so, you have to think in the minds also of the criminals din para malaman mo kung ano yung next move nila. So are you saying, ma'am, na despite your expert opinion, you cannot give us
Mr. Chair,
an opinion regarding this?
It depends on the facts of the case, Mr. Chair.
Yes or no po, ma'am?
Everything is possible, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So is it also possible na para maging very successful yung pagpatay ng tatlong Chinese nationals, na kailangan dapat na hindi makisawsaw or hindi dapat involved yung warden or mag-back out yung warden para smooth yung operation sa pagpatay ng tatlong Chinese nationals noon?
Your Honor, everything is possible.
Nangyari na po ito, ma'am. Which means na in order for that operation to be successful, kailangan dapat na mag-back out yung warden. Pero dahil kasi hindi siya nag-back out, kailangan dapat ng other methods of force, such as threats or bribes. Superintendent Padilla, kung hindi kayo bribe or threaten, papayag ba kayo na may mangyari ng ganyan sa loob ng DAPICOL under your watch?
No, Your Honor.
Correct. Kasi yung pangalan nyo, yung lulutaw as the person responsible. So, Mr. Chair, I'd like to point out, Mr. Chair, na there are very many inconsistencies again. The reason why na we brought out the hypotheticals po is because na in order for an operation this complex to happen, there are many moving parts na kailangan dapat mangyari. And one critical part that has to happen is that dapat hindi involved or dapat there is the omission of the then warden Superintendent Padilla for that operation to be very successful. Kasi kung nandun si warden, kung nakikisaw-saw si warden, kung alam ni warden na mangyayari yun at binawalan niya, then this wouldn't have happened at all. Tinatanong ko kasi yung mga katanungan ito, Colonel Garma, dahil lumalabas po sa mga testimonya ng ilang saksi na kayo po ang tinuturo bilang nag-uutos or namumuno ng operasyon sa pagpatay. Again, Colonel Garma, do you deny these allegations against you?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ito, ako pagbibigyan kita, ma'am, isasabi ko, diretso na ang pagsasagot.
Yes, Your Honor.
Kasi ang dami, pinapakinggan ko na kanina yung mga tanong. Ako nagtanong sa iyo kanina, pinakontent na kita. Because usually your answer is maybe. Maybe yes, maybe not. Simple question. Mamaya, pupuntahan kita dyan. You don't visit Jimmy Portalesa after that incident?
So, wala na po, Your Honor.
Oh, you don't bother to ask Jimmy Portalesa what really happened inside the PICOL? You're an intelligence officer. You're very close to the president. Nangyari yung patayan doon. Same is true with Colonel Grijaldo, Colonel Leonardo the time. The time because you're the CIDG. You didn't even bother to visit the PICOL. Mm.
Wala akong number sa kanya, Mr. Chair.
Hindi nga. Wala
kang
number.
How can I ask?
Oh, but some Mr. of your Chair. Classmates has a number of Jimmy Portalesa.
I don't know, Mr. Chair.
Oh, you don't know na naman. Pero ang sinasabi ko lang, you don't even bother to visit Jimmy Portalesa after the incident to check what really happens inside that colony.
No, Mr. Chair.
Oh, kaya nga eh. Ayun nga ang sinasabi ko eh. Na nagbisita kayo, may nangyari, after that, you didn't even bother. Kailan ka na promote as full colonel?
2018, Your Honor.
2018?
18? 16? Yeah,
18,
Your Honor.
Sigurado ka?
Yes, Your Honor. 2018.
Sigurado ka?
Yes,
2018 of?
I think June, Your Honor.
Oh, parang?
June.
Eto.
It's June ma'am. Of 2018, Your Honor.
Oh, ma'am, kasi yung mga ganyan after. Sa pulis, ako hindi ako pulis, pero as far as I know, pagdating dun sa colonel na posisyon hanggang general, hindi malilimutan ng general o colonel na napromote siya this year and this month. Well, in fact, even the date. Because that is an important promotion for each and every career officers in the PNP.
Ako, Your Honor.
Napromote ka na?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ba't OIC lang status mo dun?
It has to be confirmed by the mayor, Your Honor.
Ayun. Because the mayor does not want you to be the chief of police because prior to that, you were also assigned in Cebu, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
As what?
CIDG.
CIDG?
Regional Chief of Region 7.
Correct. Kaya kilala ka ni Mayor Osmeña.
Yes, Your
Kaya Honor. Kaya ayaw niya. Kasi kung kilala ka ni Mayor Osmeña because the regional center of Region 7 is Cebu. The regional office of CIDG is Cebu. Most of the activity of CIDG is in Cebu. And as the mayor that time of Cebu, kilala ka ni Mayor Osmeña. That is why ayaw niya sa'yo. Because on your record during the time, napakarami pong nangyari during the time. And we are now collating all those incident, no, related to death nung time na yon as CIDG Region 7 at the same time Chief of Police of Cebu. Now, I have with me your travel record.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Your travel for just 2024, you traveled 6 times abroad. Just in 2024. Tapos, yung travel mo 2023 is 13 times. You traveled 13 times abroad. 13 times. This is a record coming from the Bureau of Immigration, Madam. You cannot deny this. Iba't ibang lugar, may Kuala Lumpur, may ano, you're not anymore an official of the government. This is an official travel.
I paid for it, Your Honor.
Yeah, you paid for it. How much is your, ano? How much is your, can you provide us? Are you willing to have a waiver for your bank accounts?
No, Your Honor.
No. Why? Because you're not telling the truth. You are hiding something. Ito, initial pa lang, Mama. Oh. You travel 13 times. Ibig sabihin on more than every month you travel outside in the country. Now, last question ko, Ma'am. What is, ito, Mama, diretso kita, what is your latest travel abroad? When was that? When was that?
Japan, Your Honor.
Japan? Hindi, your purpose of your travel.
USA, Your Honor.
Oh, USA. Now, pakiano lang, what happened with the travel?
Okay, I have to travel to USA to
bring, why?
To bring my daughter in the US.
Why?
Because of this exposure.
When was that? When was that? When was that?
September, August, Mr. Chair.
Your plan to travel in the US was August 28. That was the time that the squad com has already started, di ba? The investigation.
Yes, Your Honor.
And your name was already cropped up.
Yes, tama? Your Honor.
Oh. Now, in short, you're using that alibi to bring your daughter to the U.S. to evade this investigation.
No, Your Honor.
No, okay. Why did... Anong nangyari? Ba't hindi ka naka-US? Ba't nandito ka ngayon?
My visa, US visa was canceled.
Why?
Hindi po sinabi sa akin ang reason why.
Hindi sinabi? You never asked?
I asked, but Japan in charge on the desk did not tell me the reason.
No, kasi papasok ka sa US, di ba? Kasi kung hindi ka tinanggap ng Japan, that is the responsibility of Japan. But you were not allowed, di ba, to go to U.S. because what?
It was not explained to me by the in-charge sa Japan po. I wasn't able to get a seat kasi nag-e-error na yung system.
Sandali.
So we sought the
balikan ko muna.
Yes po.
So yung travel mo is from the Philippines connecting Japan to
Japan.
U.S.
Yes, Your Honor.
You have a ticket, Philippines, Japan, U.S.
Yes, Your Honor.
Are you sure of that?
Ang binigay po ng...
Sandali! Ito na lang kita. Simple na ito, ma'am. Do not evade my question.
Okay, yes, Your Honor.
Your ticket is, as you have said, your ticket is Philippines, Japan, U.S.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, but you were not allowed. Yun na, may ticket ka. Anong airlines? Oh, hindi mo na naman masagot. Simpleng-simple yan.
Japan Airlines.
It happens last 2 weeks ago. Sige nga. Kasi you're lying, ma'am.
No, Mr. Jeff.
You are lying.
Japan, I think it's Japan Airlines, that's why we landed.
Why
Japan.
I think na naman? Kanina maybe, now I think.
It is Japan Airlines, Mr. Chair.
From the Philippines?
I'm very sure of it na, I can recall it, Japan Airlines.
From the Philippines?
To Japan.
To Japan? Then what airlines supposedly to the US?
It's the same, it's Japan Airlines.
Japan Airlines. And also, Mr. Chairman, can we ask the FAA the reason why Ms. Garma was not permitted to travel to have an entry from Japan to the US?
Ano ang intention mo talaga nung bumili ka ng ticket? Japan or US?
US, okay. US, Mr. Chair.
Eh bakit hindi ka kumuha ng buong ticket diretsyong papuntang US? Why do you have to procure a ticket doon sa Japan?
No, Mr. Chair, I did not procure a ticket sa Japan. I procured the ticket already.
So, stopover mo lang.
Stopover lang po ang Japan.
Japan. And yes. You were not allowed to board papuntang US.
Kasi po,
ganun ba yun na nangyari?
Yes, Mr. Chair. But hindi ako makakuha ng boarding,
Boarding pass?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Kasi yun naman ang kailangan mo eh.
Yes.
Di ba?
Yes, Mr.
Kasi
Chair.
Kasi may schedule na flight papuntang US. Nakasakay ka ron. Stopover sa Japan.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
How many hours?
10 hours, Mr. Chair.
10 hours?
Yes po.
So, nung magbo-board ka ng Japan Airlines for the US, hindi ka na pinapasok?
Yes, Mr.
Ganun
Chair.
Ganun na nangyari?
Opo, Mr. Chair.
Ma'am, di ba pag pumupunta tayo ng US, from the Philippines, chicheck na yung US visa mo dito sa Pilipinas. Pag board mo lang sa airport, bibigyan ka ng boarding pass, bibigay na yung dalawang boarding pass mo. Boarding pass from the Philippines to Japan, Japan to Philippines.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Tama po ba?
Yes po.
So, yun po yung tanong. Bakit binigyan kayo ng boarding pass na hindi na-check yung US visa? Hindi po kayo bibigyan ng boarding pass kung hindi po i-check yung US visa.
Yes,
Mr. Normal po, routine po yun pag nagpupunta tayo Amerika.
Yeah,
tama po ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Very unusual nung araw pong yun, Mr. Chair.
With regards to question of deployment, na napaka-juicy yung mga position from DIA, from tsaka puro lahat Dabaw, ang assignment except sa Cebu. Tapos nag-schooling, tapos early retirement. Again, can you state? When was your the date or the year that you retired?
That's June of 2019.
June of 2019. When did you assume as PCCO chairman?
July 15 of 2019.
Oh, 1 month lang. Di ba? Tama, 1 month?
15 days, I think, Your Honor.
Oh, 15 days pa. Sobra. Are you special and close to the president? Former president? Yes or no lang po? Walang personal? Yes or no lang po? Kasi lahat-lahat eh.
Ewan ko kung special ako.
Oh, why can't you answer? Simple lang tanong ko. Are you close to the former president? Because that's why you've been given a juicy position within, in fact, 1 month. Wala pa nga, 15 days ka lang nag-retire. PCCO chairman ka na kagad. Sige nga. Yes or no? Why can't you answer? Oh, Mr. Chairman, since
because, Mr. Chair.
Oh, why? What?
I do not
na naman.
No, Mr. Chair.
Oh, sige nga.
Because you said, am I close or special to the President?
Yeah, you're close to the President. Or special?
For me, Mr. Chair, I don't feel close and special.
Okay, now you deny. You said no. Oh, Mr. Chairman.
Can I, Mr. Chair?
Kanina pa kita pinapa-explain. Pabalik-balik lang tayo. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, ito, ano lang to, Mr. Chairman, for the record, but I moved to cite in contempt because the resource person is evading to answer questions being asked by almost all members. paulit-ulit lang yung perhaps mo. That's a motion. So, I move to site in control. Sandali lang po, co-chair. Abante, give me the time because this is my time.
Okay.
I move to cite in contempt Ms. Garma for lying and evading questions being asked by the members of this committee and including this representation. So move, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, there is
Mr. Chair.
There is Mr. Chair. Okay, is that an amendment to the motion?
Please listen to my questions first before we act on the motion of my co-chair who is angry now.
Okay. Will Congressman Abante propound questions to Colonel Garma?
I think we have a pending motion, Mr. Chairman.
No, I am just clarifying.
We just have to follow the rules first.
Oh, Mr. Chair, I accede to the motion of...
Mr. Chairman, just to clarify, the violation of Ms. Garma is refusal to answer query.
Hearing is suspended.
Yeah, suspended. Suspended tayo, mga kasama. Please, respect the decision of the chairman, please.
You can file a motion, but you have to stay here muna. You can file a motion. Kasi tatagal tayo dito. Believe you me. Kasi kanina tinanong na kita, yung states mo palang na-travel, mali-mali yung sinagot mo sa akin.
No.
Mali. I will give
Mr.
you,
Chair,
in the next hearing, Mr. Chairman, in the next hearing, tatanungin kita liwa ulit kung sasabihin mo ng totoo.
Mr. Chair, I'm telling the truth, Mr. Chair, in my mother's grave. Yung travel ko sa state, sinabi ko na po ang totoo. I don't even know the answer why my visa was invalidated by...
Hindi lang yung visa, Ms. Garma. Alam mo kung bakit ka pinigil?
No, alam. Mr. Chair. I do not know, Mr. Chair.
Anyway, Mr. Chairman, if I ask her...
Mr. Chair, I will be proven,
Mr. Chair. Point of order,
Mr. Chair.
Wait. Point
I'm
of
lying.
Order.
1 minute suspension.
I'm not lying.
Please address the chair when you reply to the question asked by a member, okay? And paki-clarify mo lang ulit ang iyong gustong sabihin. Okay,
yes, Mr. Chair.
Hearing is resumed.
I wanted to answer the questions, Mr. Chair. I have a daughter waiting for me who attempted to kill herself 3 times. I cannot leave her, Mr. Chair. She's waiting for me. She attempted 3 times, Mr. Chair. That's why I cannot leave her. Now, I will answer all your questions, Mr. Chair. With regards to my travels, that's the real answer. I do not know why my visa was canceled, Mr. Okay. Chair.
Okay.
You can validate that. If magtanong kayo sa Japan kung bakit they didn't give me the exact answer.
I think Congressman Paduano has asked several questions to you, GM Garma. Not just about your trip to Japan. So it seems that you have not answered his questions and you appear to be evading the questions that he is asking.
Yes.
And that is the reason why you were cited in contempt.
Yes, Mr. Chair, may I make a statement? That's why I'm appealing to answer. But as stated by the Honorable Congressman, Mr. Chair, he said that I was not telling the truth about my travel these days. But that's the truth. If that is the only reason, isa lang yan, ano pa yung other questions that I will answer? But with regards to my travel sa States, last travel, yun po ang totoong nangyari sa amin ng anak ko sa Japan. I do not know why my visa was invalidated according to that lady in Japan.
Chairman, to be clear, he was not contented because of that question of mine, because of the travel. And in fact, hindi ko na nga pinurso kasi it is all about the question being raised to you by the members, and you're evading the question. It is not all about the your travel in the US. Eh, hindi pa nga ako tapos doon eh. Sa totoo lang po, travel in the US, hindi pa ako tapos doon. I tell you, you were cited in contempt because you're evading question from the very start by the members of this committee. Not because my question about your US travel. And ang totoo noon, hindi pa ako tapos doon. Ms. Garma, akala mo yun lang? Hindi pa ako tapos doon. And I will prove you in the next hearing. Pag hindi ka nagsabi ng totoo, I will prove to you that you're lying. Doon lang muna. Kung yun lang yung gusto mong pag-usapan, yung travel mo sa US, if you will not tell the truth in the next hearing, I have all the proof with me.
Bring the child in here para makasama po ni Colonel Garma, yung kanya po anak. Yun lang po, Mr. Chairman. And I move to suspend this Quadcom hearing till the next hearing will be scheduled.
There is a motion to suspend.